नेक्स्ट स्पीकर श्रीमती टी सुमती।
थैंक यू ऑनरेबल स्पीकर सर। आई राइज हियर टू अपोज द जम्मू एंड कश्मीर रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन अमेंडमेंट बिल 2021। सर, एट द आउटसेट आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्रेस टू दिस ऑगस्ट हाउस दैट आई एम डीपली ग्रीव्ड एंड पेन्ड व्हेन आई हर्ड द प्राइम मिनिस्टर और ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर coining a term andolan jeevis in the context of a farmers protest. Sir, the phrase rights of man by Dellesley Burns says has helped to create two great republics of modern times in France and America, but our honorable prime minister has derogatively chosen another term, andolan jeevi, when it is the basic rights of a farmer brother and sister to protest and to show their resistance. So coming to the discussion on the bill, again this has given me an opportunity to bring to reminisce about an old term. Sir, I am concentrating on the bill only, coming to the bill only.
Or are you obsessed with other
bills? No, that is the, I have every right to express my grief, sir. Now I am coming to, I am not yielding. This is, I have every right to express my grief and pain. So coming to the bill again, this has given me an opportunity to be reminiscent about an old term called the social contract, coined by Rousseau back in Vogue. It is also a two-worded term on which the foundation of a democracy rests. It is a contract between the ruled and the rulers, where the ruled give up their freedom on an assurance by the ruler that their natural rights, namely life, liberty and property and civil rights, shall be protected. But when the Jammu and Kashmir Act 2019 was implemented, the BJP government has not only breached that contract, you have buried democracy, you have buried federalism, you have buried the rights of liberty as well as the civil rights of the people of the Kashmir. Sir, this bill, which seeks to replace the ordinance, tries to solve the issue of All India Service Offices in the two union territories created after the abrogation of the Article 370. And I have a query in that, sir, which I'll be coming soon in a bit. Sir, when you promulgated that amendment, we were told that as soon as normalcy is returned, there will be the status of the statehood will be restored. Sir, with this bill, our hope is now gone. We thought that was the last straw, but now this is the last straw. And you are going to be pinning up nail after nail after burying peace in Kashmir. Sir, in August 2019, you not only bifurcated a state, but reduced its status to that of a union territory, thereby increasing the direct central hand in day-to-day management. Sir, I am reminded of the famous opening lines of Charles Dickens' Tale of Two Cities, which said, this is the best of times and this is the worst of times. I would say this is the worst of times that India has ever witnessed in her pages of history. The BJP government has imposed all the draconian laws. You have imposed CAA, you have imposed NRC, and now the draconian anti-farmer laws, which were hanging like a Damocles sword above your head, and I'm sure definitely you will have repercussions in the forthcoming elections. Sir, I would like to quote a great Thiruvalluvar who said, Kudi thazhugi kol ochum maanila mannan adi thazhugi nirkum ulagu, meaning a king who would respect its subjects' opinion and the rule for their benefits will not only be respected but also be loved by people. Sir, I'm coming to the bill. Sir, has the BJP government opted for a referendum before revoking the Article 370? Has it cared to ask an opinion and consider the feelings? When you boast of a paperless budget, you are running a compassionless, commitmentless, dedicationless, visionless government which has brought such draconian laws. Sir, there is a tendency of the government to bypass in this parliament, to take away the people's rights and follow the ordinance route. And this is the route.
Repeatedly she is saying that the parliament has been bypassed. Similarly, Mr. Hasnain Saab also said this bill was duly passed in this house, also in the other house. You are abusing the sanctity of the parliament.
Sir, The DMK has always withstood on its principles of federalism and democracy, sir. Sir, our leader, great Anna, has evoked. We have a federal structure. That is why the framers of the constitution wanted a federal structure and not a unitary structure. I'm quoting our great leader Anna. Because many political philosophers have pointed out, India is so vast, in fact, that it has been described as a subcontinent. The mental health is so varied, the tradition so different, the history so varied, that there cannot be a steel-framed unitary structure here. Unquote. Sir, by reducing the stature of J&K from a state into union territory, you have not only failed to bring administration closer to people, but rendered a serious blow to our freedom. Now coming to the bill, sir, I have a query in that bill, I said. Coming to the statement of the object and reasons of this bill, it states that Section 88 of the said Act provides that the members of the cadres of Indian Administrative Service, Indian Police Service and Indian Forest Service for the existing state of Jammu and Kashmir shall continue to function on the existing cadres. There is a huge deficiency of the offices of all India services in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. Sir, I am maybe forgiven for my ignorance, but I would like to get a clear explanation of this phrase, huge deficiency. What do they mean by this huge deficiency, sir? And it is supplemented by another sentence. The developmental schemes, centrally sponsored schemes and other allied activities suffer due to non-availability of all India offices in the existing cadres of the Jammu and Kashmir. As such, there is a requirement of merging it with Arunachal Pradesh, Goa, Mizoram, Union Territories cadres so that the offices in this cadre can be posted in the Union Territory of J&K to meet out any deficiency to come out. Sir, your government boasts itself on pioneering Atmanirbhartha or self-dependence. If there is huge deficiency of the officers in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir to meet out any challenges, then why not put more effort in making it as a more self-reliant from the local officers themselves? Why must we have to merge the cadre and have the region depend on the other states? So here also I am reminded of a quote by Rousseau who said, to form a state, not only the intelligent or the competent enter the contract, but all, both intelligent and the non-intelligent. As parties to agreement, all are equal, though in other ways they are dissimilar. This is the meaning of political equality. How to make this real? It is difficult to say, but equality is not a kimaru, and it is the duty of the government to maintain equality in even appointing or in even the maintenance of the cadre status. Sir, the section, coming to section 3 of the bill, which amends section 88 again, it says, the officers so born are allocated on Arunachal Pradesh, Goa, Mizoram, United Union Territories, cadre shall function in accordance with the rules framed by the central government. Here the cat is out of the bag and the skeleton comes from the cupboard, because rules framed by the central government is the key sentence wherein the federal rights of the state are put at stake, and this is a nail straightly placed on the coffin of democracy and the federal structure. Sir, if you are going to mandate this, the successors of you, if you are going to mandate this sort of modus operandi with a lot of brutal majority, what is the guarantee that tomorrow with the same modus operandi, the government can bifurcate states like West Bengal, Kerala and Tamil Nadu? Because I'm sure they are going to lose in the electoral mandate with the support of our people. Sir, our party leader, Mr. M.K. Stalin, has strongly opposed all these draconian laws, and I also place it on record here that I oppose this bill vehemently. And let me conclude this by saying that John Locke, the father of liberalism, had argued that the obligation to obey civil government under the social contract was conditional upon protection of the person. Sovereigns who violated these terms could be justifiably overthrown. Revolt is the right of the people, for when injustice becomes law, resistance becomes duty. Thank you very much.